This is tips 14 for Rogue Galaxy. I'm just about to go into Gladius Towers to pick up one of the key pieces for the SP folder. But I thought I'd do a bit of factory before I go in there. Pikachu's office, I've just been in there and I've bought a load of stuff in the shop. And I just need to go to the factory and show you what I'm going to do next. So the blueprints I'm going to do are the defences, which are the easiest ones really, because you've only got two production lines. One of them's for metal and one of them's for the alchemy materials. We've got plenty of those because I've just bought them. And I've been picking up loads of alchemy stuff, so we've got loads of mushrooms there, that's alright. Super. So we're just going to place the equipment, and because all of these defences are similar, you only have to set up the equipment once and you can knock out about 8 items. Now, because the metal takes a lot longer to build than the other material, I'm going to set that up first. So you're going to need to melt the metal, and then you need to press it, and then you need to cool it down. So I'm just going to put a bit of a little cooler there, like so, and I'll just put in a just need an assembler. Way. Put an end table like that. Now what we do now is we count up this side, because this takes the longest bit to do. And when I mean count, you can see that time one, so we've got 1, 5, which is 6, which is 9, 10, 11, 12. So we've got 12 points of time that we need to replicate on this side so that we can get the components to the assembler at the same time. So let's do 12, just place some bits and pieces. That's what you need for the... Now I've got a feeling that's the wrong way around. Let's put it in that way. So that's 6, see that? So now we've got 8. We just need to make that up to 12 now. So we've got 8, 9, 10, 12. I might have to double check that, because I'm going to put the materials on there now, because nothing's going to mess you up more than getting that bit wrong. So make sure you put the metal on the metal bit and the alchemy on the alchemy bit, because I've done that wrong before. So we've got the materials, looks like we're all set up. Let's just double check. So we know this is 12, but let's just double check. So we've got 3 there with the bits. Another 3, 6, 5 is 11, 12, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12, right. That should be perfect. All we need to do is put the electricity in. These are nice, easy ones to show you for the old factory. It does get a bit hairy later on. Does that press everyone on either side? Yes, it does. Okay. Sometimes you can kind of run out of power cord, which is, I know, insane, but that's just part of the game. And you have to sort of rip up everything and start again. So the astronaut looks like we're okay. So now we can go ahead and run it. So we just circle back to the run screen. There we go. So the little machines, they bring them down to component parts. We get to the assembler at the right time. There you go. And now you can pick the next one, freeze defense, iron board and alchemy ingredient, and you can just carry on placing. I'll just show you another one really quickly. I need another iron, but you need quite a few of these iron boards. So freeze defense, you need three, I'm thinking probably these. It might not be these, so this will be a bit of a learning thing. It could be the other. Oh, would it be something hot? Let's just go and have a check the old blueprint, what's it say? That's not very good, is it? Freeze defense. I will give it a go. If it's wrong, it's wrong. It might actually be the opposite. It might. I need to put some hot things there rather than freezing things. Okay, that was a little bit easier than I thought. Okay, right, just overthinking that, obviously. So, yeah, you just keep doing that. Alchemy ingredients, so what have you got there? Daze defense. So it'll be something that causes daze, obviously. Super hard, seems like, so just try this one out and give it a go. Perfect. So, yeah, so it's literally that. Yeah. You can find them in the shops now as well. I suppose I might as well do them all while I'm here. I've only got four more. Alchemy ingredient for shop defense, so I'm guessing that's going to be. Shock defense, so I'm thinking it's going to be an electric eel, yeah. Oh, no, no, I need three of those. Perfect. Run. So, the good thing to do is really get a lot of the blueprints together and figure out which ones are the same, so a metal, an alchemy, you know, circuit, whatever. If they've got similar ingredients, as in a metal or an alchemy ingredient, you can just whack a load out one after the other. Maybe I haven't got one of those. Well, anyway, you get the picture, don't you? So. Oh! Right. I didn't know that caused paralyze. Okay, let's see that on there. You get the picture. I mean, it's not rocket science, really. But it's nice to know what you're doing to begin with, and you won't make mistakes and waste your own time, so. Actually, and stuff. You can stick them on your people, and you can be. Some of your characters actually do have natural immunities to some of these, so you can just give them the ones that they're not immune to. I'll do this last one here, and then. Okay, so what we want? This is a poison. I'm just going to go and get myself some more metal, but you get the picture. Try and group the products into same type ingredients that needs to make them up, or if they've got two production lines or three production lines. Some of them have got four production lines when it gets a bit trickier later, which can be, you might just have to rebuild each one for that, but this is a good place to come to buy your stuff. Some of the items you won't be able to make until the very end anyway, because let's get 71 of those. Because you won't have the items, they turn up in dungeons later on. So, you know, just try and do as much as you can.